Craft. Nee. Space engineers. Which is this little bugger? The conveyor sorter. Very useful. And now, all cobalt, iron, and nickel will automatically be taken into the arc furnaces. And the refineries will take everything else. And not only that, both will be automatically emptied of their ingots due to this little system, which the developers was kind enough to show. It's a pretty useful system. I've used it quite a few things. And I've just moved the assemblers down here. And I think there's actually more assemblers now than what there was before. As for the gyros, I think there is a lot more now than what there was before. Yeah, there's a lot. And anyway, I think that's it. I'm not sure I actually shown you guys the insides. Well, let's go to this room and I'll show you just quickly. I'll be cutting this part out if it's already in. Anyway, this only has a few seats. There's no personal lodges, which I was originally going to be putting in, but I kind of forgot, but never mind. And this is the medbay. Medbay, and I've only got two. I was going to put three. I guess I could have put one there. That means removing that. You know what? Let's stick one in. Alrighty then, where's the medibay? Medibay! And do that. Turn off the mirroring. Rotate. Won't go there. Due to that piece. And there we go. It's now placed. Now we have three medibays in this area. Which is good. Because now there was plenty for every player. I guess having them more scattered out would be more useful. Because they're just going to have six of those mobile bases. There's going to be another six anyway. And also, something else I'd like to mention is that this is probably best for servers where you got at least six players. Well, seven players in the server. Considering, you know, there's six of these things to drop down. And there needs to be one player who's controlling the darn thing. Yeah, I like the way I designed this. Anyhoodle. I'm going to summon in one of those little bases, and then we'll be right back. And we're back. And since this thing has actually been updated and fixed, before I even mentioned that it was broken in the first episode, which makes me feel stupid, that it no longer spins out of control. But I think that might have altered a few things, which is why my connectors, thingies, broke. Mergers. Anyway, for now, to see if we can actually get it working, we will make a new ship. Large one, but you know, it's going to need to be large. Anyway, place that there. And let's get back here. Place that there. Across there. Oh. Well. That could cause a few problems. It's a tad bit longer than 10 cubes. That's no good. Anyway. Let's put that there. And as a cross, it's 6. So I'll just stick another one of those there, and stick two coming out of each side, like that. Since it's 10.5, I don't know what I'm going to do about that. There's got to be something I can do. I guess a piston? I guess that would work. Oh, bugger. I was changing my menus, but I ended up typing stuff in as well. Oh, I've already got a piston there. Anyway. just need to get a piston stuck in here. Like that. And another one. No. Like that. Now the guy who made that thing down there, Wasted Space, as he likes to call himself. Oh, it's got gyroscopes on it. Nicely fitted gyroscopes too. Didn't notice that. Alright, he's got a technique where you can get multiple rotors and pistons connected to the same object. I just don't know how to do it myself. Now, is that all connected? Yeah, that's connected. If I do that one, won't let me do it. A bugger. But it will there. And it counts as both of them being connected. Hmm. Interesting. Well, anyway. Now all I need to do is get these connected. Which, a simple block would be good for that. A merger! And insert. And we're back after several hours. Yeah, it took a while. Either way, I have got those linked thanks to Wasted Space, because I actually finally seen the video on how he does it. It was so simple. Which, since I need to do it on all these other pistons, why aren't they gone? Oh, give me a sec. Let me just get rid of these pistons. And yes, didn't get rid of anything I wanted to keep. There goes that. And there goes that. And the bin. And here it is. There we go. That's that done. And how he managed to do them, it's quite ingenious. First, he'll do that. Whoops, do that. He's on there. No, not that yet. And now you're wondering, why this? How does that become that? Well, it's all just the magic of mergers. Let's just get these ones on. And now that one. But when I come here, it won't allow it. However, how we deal with that problem is by going up above. Would have been easy if I didn't put all those panels on yet, but never mind. And here we go. And that thing down there is actually providing power. And now, select that, and put it in reverse. Although I think it might be a good idea to put all of them in reverse, because I've adjusted the minimum settings without extending any of them. And now down we go again. And we get our merge block back. You rotate, place on there. Now all you do is let them merge. And that will make both blocks a single type. However, to get the minimum distance sorted, considering that one will have a smaller minimal distance than this one, it could cause some problems. Didn't want to go into that one. Well, it's cargo slot anyway. And boom! It will now merge into a single piece. Which means it'll work, but you can't activate them independently. You must now activate them at the same time, every time. Which is a bit of a problem. And I've just realized how far down the platform needs to go to actually connect to that thing. And there you go, connected. I go here, I can now put a block there, and both blocks are now connected as one. And that's Bay 2. I haven't even named this thing yet. No, that's not it. This is it. Okay, let's see. No, that's not it either. Do I even access this ship? Weird. Never mind. That's the only way it's going on here anyway. Oh my. Well, anyway, just need to move up here. And again. And now, this is Piston Bay 2-2. Don't ask me about the naming. Anyway, just click on the group 2 for the pistons and shrink them. I should really do that for all of them. Whee! And there you go, it's now going in as a group. And I've also added on, oh wait, yeah, though, landing gear to hold it in place more securely, because I'm not too sure about leaving it on just a pair there. Considering those ones don't line up anymore, they're kind of useless. I would take them off myself, but I don't know if I'll break the darn thing. And plus, it's not my thing. So any changes I do would not be affected to anyone else who has actually downloaded the blueprint from the workshop. So yeah, you can do it yourself if you want. That's up to you. For whether or not any changes done to this is all down to wasted space. I'm just curious, can I actually stand on these things? Don't mind me, I'm just doing something weird. Yay! I can stand on them! Bring it around them though. Ooh, can I do it? Can I do it? Yay! Well, anyway, that's pretty much how this section is done, which I will get back to you once I've finished it. Although, before I do disappear to work on them, because it won't take long, I'm actually going to start here. Because now I just need to put armor plating on top of all this to make it not look as cluttered and less of a shiny flat plane. And the best way to do this is to go to armor blocks, give it a moment to load, and here we go. Oh, that's heavy version, we don't want heavies. We'll just bring all these down. Although I think there's a bit too many to put on these. Oh well. Now since this isn't evenly spaced, I think I may actually start with this one. Just considering, well, just because of how wide it is. Unless I make it, yeah, I'm going to go with my original idea. Make it two different sections. Which require this one. And insert. Yep, that's the middle piece, and this will have to come about here, and then there. Now this piece, there, and then it just keeps on going wider and wider. Because the next piece we're going to need is this one. There we go. Put that there, and there. And get this one. Which is then placed there. And there. There we go, we're now covering up the conveyor tubes. Don't really want those exposed. They don't look too pretty. Anyway, I'll just be continuing doing this crazy stuff. But I'm going to have to keep making it go higher as well in order to cover everything. And that's pretty much all I need to do for now. And I will return once it's all been completed. Please do not ask me what happened. It just spazzed out once I loaded. I just loaded the game. Well, the save, because I need to continue it, because something went wrong. And then it decided to zoom up in my face and do this. So yeah, I got a few repairs to do before we continue. And I'll be back once that's done. And welcome back, where I've attempted like 8 or so times to get this particular one on, and the result is always the same. It snaps the pistons. Rather annoying. But I will get them all on eventually, mainly because I want them all on for demonstration purposes,